To me, one of the things in history the most to be regretted is that the Christ's own Renaissance, which has produced the cathedral at Chartres, the Arthurian cycle of legends, the life of St. Francis of Assisi, the art of Giotto, and Dante's Divine Comedy, was not allowed to develop on its own lines. But it was interrupted and spoiled by the dreary classical Renaissance that gave us Petrarch and Raphael's frescoes and Palladian architecture and formal French tragedy and St. Paul's Cathedral and Pope's poetry and everything that is made from without and by dead rules and does not spring from within through some spirit informing it. But wherever there is a romantic movement in art, there is somehow, and under some form, is Christ or the soul of Christ. He is in Romeo and Juliet, in The Winter's Tale, in Provençal poetry, in The Ancient Mariner, in La Belle Dame sans Merci, and in Chatterton's Ballad of Charity. We owe to him the most diverse things and people, Hugo's Les Miserables, Baudelaire's Fleur de Mal, the note of pity in Russian novels, Verlaine and Verlaine's poems, the stained glass and tapestries and the Quattrocento work of Burne Jones and Morris, belonging to him no less than the Tower of Giotto, Lancelot and Guinevere, Tannhauser, the troubled romantic marbles of Michelangelo, pointed architecture, and the love of children and flowers, for both of which, indeed, in classical art, there was but little place, hardly enough for them to grow or play in, but which, from the 12th century down to our own day, have been continually making their appearances in art under various modes and at various times, coming fitfully and willfully, as children as flowers are apt to do.